Chatsurunmilitanyena tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Vanchakalpatarubhyascha kripa sindubhayevacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha. Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine. Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, tomorrow is the auspicious day of the appearance day of Lord Vamanadev. So I wanted to speak about the appearance of Lord Vamanadev. So this is described in the 8th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. So Bali Maharaj is born in the family of the demons.
Bali Maharaj 呢，是出生在恶魔的家庭之中。
And his grandfather is the great devotee Prahlad Maharaj.
他的祖父呢，是一个非常伟大的奉献者 Prahlad Maharaj.
So there's always conflict between the demons and the demigods.
在这个恶魔和半神人之间呢，总是有争斗.
So it happened, Bali Maharaj came to fight with the demigods.
这发生在巴利马哈拉吉，就和这个半世人之间呢，就有一场战斗。
But before he came, he did, first of all, he performed a yagya.
在他去参加这场战斗之前呢，他从事了一场祭祀的活动。
He did a yagya which helped him to get great power.
他通过这个yagya想获得巨大的力量。
And from the yagya, he was given a very special chariot, and he was given other different paraphernalia which he could use to fight with.
通过这场祭祀，他得到了一个非常有力的战车，而且还有其他的一些用品，让他能够在这场战斗中获得力量。
So, when Bali Maharaj came to the heavenly planets with his army of the demons, the demigods were very afraid.
当巴利马哈拉吉和他的这个恶魔的战士们来到天堂星球的时候，这个天堂星球的这些半神人非常的害怕。
Because they knew that Bali Maharaj had got the mercy of his spiritual master.
他们知道巴利马哈拉吉从他的灵性导师那里获得了非常大的仁慈。
The spiritual master of Bali Maharaj was called Sukra Acharya.
巴利马哈拉吉的灵性导师的名字叫舒卡尔查尔。
So he's a very powerful Brahmana.
他是一个有力量的婆罗门。
He is mentioned also in the 10th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, where Krishna describes his vibhutis, his opulences.
当 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中的第十篇的时候，描述他的富裕的时候，同样提到了这个舒帕叉人的名字。
So, from the yagya, Bali was given a very special bow and special armor, and also special arrows.
从这个祭祀之中呢，巴利马哈拉吉获得了非常特别的弓箭，那个弓筒，还有其他的一些武器。
And Prahlad Maharaj, his grandfather, had given him a very special garland of eternal flowers.
他的祖父 Prahlad Maharaj 给了他一个很特别的花环，一串永恒的鲜花花环。
And his guru, Shukracharya, gave him a conch shell.
他的灵性导师 Shukracharya 给了他一个海螺。
So Bali Maharaj was very careful to do everything according to the proper etiquette, not to offend anyone.
所以巴利马哈拉吉他非常小心地从事这一切，尽量非常不要非常避免的冒犯到任何一个人。
So he offered his obeisances to Prahlad Maharaj and to the Brahmanas and to his guru.
所以他向 Prahlad Maharaj 做出顶拜，向婆罗门以及他的尼性导师做出顶拜。
And in this way, he went to Indra's capital with all of his soldiers.
在这之后呢，他和他的所有的士兵都来到了 Indra 的这个首都。
And when Indra saw the army of Bali, then he was shocked. He was very worried.
当 Indra 看到了巴利马哈拉吉来了之后，他非常的震惊，然后呢，他也非常担心。
So he went to his guru. His guru is called Brihaspati.
所以他又向他的灵性导师去，去到那里。他的 Indra 的灵性导师叫 Brihaspati。
Yeah, the guru of the demigods is called Brihaspati.
半神人们的灵性导师叫 Brihaspati.
And the guru of the demons is called Shukracharya.
恶魔们的灵性导师叫做 Shukracharya.
So.Brihaspati, he knew that the demons had become very powerful because Bali had pleased the Brahmanas.
Brihaspati 明白恶魔们现在变得非常有力量，因为他们取悦了婆罗门。
And he told Indra, he said, "Your demigods will never be able to defeat Bali Maharaj."
这个 Brihaspati 告诉 Indra, 你们这些半神人是不可能打败这个巴利马哈拉吉。
You have to get the blessings of the Supreme Lord.
你们应该去找至尊人格首神获得他的仁慈才行。
But Indra didn't know how he could approach the Supreme Lord.
但是 Indra不知道他怎么样，因着自己不知道他应该怎样去接近至尊人格首神。
So Indra decided he would have to go into hiding.
所以 Indra 这个时候考虑到他应该躲起来。
Make himself invisible, the different demigods, all of them, that they left the heavenly planets and they just made themselves invisible.
因着和天堂星宿的这些半神们呢，就让他们自己躲起来，反正不被发现。
And in this way, Bali Maharaj became the ruler of the heavenly planets.
于是这样呢，巴利马哈拉吉就成了天堂的这个掌管者。
The heavenly planets is very opulent, so that the demons could enjoy.
天堂星宿非常富裕，所以呢，这些恶魔们就可以在那里享受。
But the problem was, one person was not happy. Of course, that's the mother of all the demigods.
但是呢，有一个人当时并不开心。那个人就是半食人们的母，恶魔们的母亲。
The mother of the demigods is called Aditi.
恶魔们的母亲，半食人的母亲，她的名字叫做 Aditi.
There are two sisters, Diti and Aditi.
她们是两姐妹 ，Diti 和 Aditi。
Diti was the mother of Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha, the demons.
Diti is the mother of the demons. She is Hiranyakashipu's mother.
And Aditi, she's the mother of the demigods.
Sorry, Gurudev. Aditi is
the mother. Aditi is the mother of the demigods.
对。Aditi is the mother of the demons.
And they both have the same husband, the two sisters, Aditi and Diti, they're both married to Kashyapa Muni.
Aditi and Diti, these two sisters, they both married to Kashyapa Muni.
Well, Kashyapa Muni is a great sage, he's very powerful.
Kashyapa Muni 是一个非常伟大的圣人，很有力量。
So because the demigods had to leave the heavenly planets, so Aditi was feeling very sorry that she was missing her sons.
Aditi 当时非常感到抱歉。
Aditi.
Aditi 当时感觉到非常难过，因为他的这些天堂半神的这些。儿子们都不在，他将失去这些儿子们。
So she told her husband came home and he could see how in the home everybody was very sad.
所以当她的丈夫卡夏帕穆里回到家中的时候，发现所有人都非常的悲伤。
So he wondered what was wrong.
他在询问到底发生了什么事情。
So his wife told him about how she was missing her children.
所以他就告诉他的丈夫，他是如何的想念他的孩子们。
So her husband tried to preach to her.
他的丈夫这个时候就想向他传教。
Tried to tell her, you shouldn't be worried about.You know, material attachment. This is just material attachment. That your sons will be all right. You don't have to worry. You don't have to be so sad. They can look after themselves.
这个她的丈夫就跟她说，这只是物质的境况，你不应该变得如此的伤心。这只是很短暂的这个情况，你不应该很伤心。他们会照顾好自己的。
But.He was not able to satisfy Aditi.
但是他无法满足，无法还是无法令 Aditi 感到满意。
So then, he told her, "You should worship Lord Vasudev."
所以卡夏帕穆尼告诉Aditi, 你应该崇拜 Vasudeva.
And he told her about a special process.Where it was only for 12 days. She had to follow this process for 12 days.
她应该去做一个仪式，做一个这个仪式呢，有12天的这种崇拜。
And for these 12 days, she has to live on just drinking milk.
在这个十二天里面，她只应该喝牛奶。
And she also has to worship Lord Vasudev.
同时他应该崇拜主 Vasudeva.
So Kashyapa told his wife about how to do this.
Kashyapa Muni 告诉 Aditi 他如何做这个仪式。
So Aditi, did she followed the process? She did it very nicely, and the Lord Vasudeva was very pleased.
Aditi 呢就按照这个程序做呢，主 Vasudeva 也非常的满意。
And the Supreme Lord appeared before her in four, with his four hands in yellow cloth.
主至尊人格首神呢，也因此显现在他面前，自闭的形象，黄色的这个外套衣服。
So when Aditi saw the Lord, she became ecstatic and she stood up and she offered obeisances, fell on the ground, offered obeisances.
当 Aditi 看到至尊人格首神的时候，他陷入了狂喜，然后拜倒在地上，献出顶拜。
She wanted to offer prayers, but she couldn't think of what to say.
他想献上祷文，但是他想不起来应该怎么说。
Then the Supreme Lord, he told her.
这个时候，至尊人格首神就跟他说。
Well, first of all, after some time, she offered her prayers. She did offer prayers.
过了一段时间，他。这个Aditi 才献出了祷文。
And the Lord was very satisfied, and he told her that I'm going to become your son.
至尊人格首神说，我对你非常满意，我会显现为您的儿子。
That your husband is also pleasing me. Your husband is very a good.Brahmana, he's done great austerities. I'm very pleased with both of you.
您的丈夫呢，也是一个非常不错的婆罗门。他做了很多的苦行，我对你们两个人都感到满意。
So then, Kashyapa Muni, he did some meditation and he saw the Lord within him.
这个卡夏帕穆尼做了一些冥想，这个冥想的时候，他就发现主和他在一起。
And then he placed his semen in the womb of Aditi.
然后这个至尊主就进入到 Aditi 的子宫之中。
And then they knew that the Lord had entered into the womb of Aditi.
卡夏帕穆尼看见他这个至尊主就进入到阿迪提的子宫里面。
So when the Lord appeared from the womb of Aditi, he came fully dressed.
当这个至尊主进入到阿迪提的子宫的时候，他整个都就是打扮得很好。
He had four arms, and he was carrying the conch shell, the disc, and the lotus, and the club.
至尊人格首神，他这个时候是四臂的形体，穿着黄色的衣服，然后手持海螺。
海螺、disc、club、lotus。
还有海螺、莲花。
Club。
感香棒
and lotus.
莲花
and these are the four symbols of Vishnu. Lord Vishnu carries in his four hands.
这个是 Vishnu 四臂有的这个形体，四臂的手上持的这些标志。
And his body was black, and he was dressed in yellow cloth.
他穿着这个黄色的衣服。刚刚说掉了，还有一个神碟、神杵、莲花、海螺。
And he appeared on the very auspicious day tomorrow, which is called Shravana Dwadesi.
就显现在明天的这个节日，这个日子叫 Shravana Dwadesi。
So when the Lord appeared, everyone was very happy.
当主显现了, 所有的人都非常的开心。
All the brahmanas and all the cows and the different inhabitants of the heavenly planets, they all knew the Lord had appeared.
所有的婆罗门, 奶牛,
so after he appeared, then he took the form of a dwarf.
当他显现的时候, 他显现为一个侏儒的形象。
And then they arranged a nice ceremony to honor the Lord. Lord Vamana. Vamana means a dwarf. So they give a nice ceremony to honor him. They give him the sacred thread that he's a Brahmana.
Mm. 当他显现的时候是显现为一个侏儒的形象，这个时候他们做了一个祭祀，然后也给他挂了一个圣线，他是一个婆罗门。And
he was dressed like a great, he was dressed like a brahmachari. He was dressed with a deer skin.
他这个时候打扮的像一个小鹿一样，是一个非常可爱的，是一个 brahmacharya 的形象，真守身。
He was covered. He wore a deer skin, 鹿皮。
他穿着一个鹿皮。
Yeah, and he was carrying in his hand the brahmachari danda.
他还有一个danda在这个手上。
And he had
就是那个棍。
He had an umbrella.
他还举着一把伞。
Yeah, the king, a great ruler, powerful, but they will have a white umbrella.
当一个有力量的国王的时候，他会有一个白色的伞。
Not just like an umbrella which we have to protect us from the rain, but it's a symbol of honor for a very great personality.
这个伞不仅仅是为了防雨用的，它是对一个非常伟大人物，它有这个伞的时候是一种象征，一种标志。And
then he also had a kamandalu, which means the water pot.
他还提着一个水罐。You
see that when Lord Chaitanya was traveling, he also carried. In one hand he has a danda, and the other hand he has a kamandalu, water pot.
当主柴坦尼亚显现以及他主柴坦尼亚旅行的时候，他一个手拿着水罐，一个手拿着一个棍子，danda.
Just like we carry a bottle of water, so the great sages and so on, they carry the water pot that they can purify their hands anytime, and they can drink water also.
就像我们平常也会带着一罐，带着一瓶水。这些伟大的圣人们，他们平时也会带一个水罐，一方面呢用于清洁他的手，另外一个方面他渴的时候可以喝水。
So it's described when he appeared, when Lord Vamana appeared, all the brahmanas and all the great sages, they all offered respects to him.
所以这里描述了当主瓦玛纳显现的时候，所有的这个圣人，所有的婆罗门都向他献上了尊敬。And
Lord Shiva takes the water from the feet, which wash the feet of Lord Vamanadeva. Lord Shiva takes that on his head as the Ganges water.
就连主西瓦都用头接受了源于主瓦玛纳德瓦足底的这个水。
And Bali Maharaj, he also took the water which washed Vamanadeva's feet. He also took it on his head. Bali Maharaj.
Bali Maharaj 呢也接受了这个主洗脚的洗脚水.
So Bali Maharaj, he could understand Vamanadeva is the son of a Brahmana.
Bani Maharaj 呢，他能够明白，Vamana Dev 是一个婆罗门的儿子。
So, because Bali Maharaj is Kshatriya, he likes to give charity to the Brahmanas.
因为 Bali Maharaj 呢是一个 Kshatriya, 他希望给布施给予这些婆罗门。
So, Bali Maharaj asked Vamana Dev what he would like, what he could give him as charity.
Bali Maharaj 呢就问这个 Vamana Dev， 你想要什么？你想要什么作为这个布施？我想给予你。
And Lord Vamana Dev is very clever. He begins by saying nice words about the forefathers of Bali Maharaj. He talks about how great Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha were.
Vamana Dev 呢非常的聪明，他首先呢荣耀了巴尼马哈拉吉，荣耀了他的四位父亲，讲述了这个黑人亚卡西普他们是如何的有力量。
Yeah. He said, Lord, it's a Hiranyakashipu, a Hiranyaksha. They were great heroes.
他说黑人亚卡西普，黑人亚亚卡。他们都是非常伟大的英雄。
And they died in a very glorious death.
他们以一种非常荣耀的方式死亡了。
And Bali Maharaj was very fortunate to be born in their family.
而 Bali Maharaj 呢，出生在这样的家庭之中，非常的幸运。
So then Lord Vamana Dev.He asked Bali Maharaj, he said, just give me three steps of land.
这个时候呢 Vamana Dev 就跟 Bali Maharaj 说他只需要三步的这个土地。
So Bali Maharaj was thinking, this is why you only ask for this, you should take more.
巴尼马哈拉吉呢就说你为什么只要这么一点地方，你应该要更多。
But Lord Vamana Dev said, no, I should be satisfied. If I'm not satisfied with three steps of land, I won't be satisfied with three planets.
这个时候 Vamana Dev 就说不，我应该对我的所有的这个情况感到满足。如果我对三部土地都不感到满足的话，那么给我三个星球，我仍然会感到不满足。
So in this way, Lord Vamana Dev, he has to get the confidence of Bali Maharaj.
所以呢，Vamana Dev 呢，这个时候就给了 Bali Maharaj 这种信心。
Yeah, that Bali Maharaj.Doesn't want to think anything bad about Vamana Dev. He should understand he's a Brahmin.
Vamana Dev, 他这个时候理解到他是一个婆罗门，理解到 Bani Maharaj 理解到 Vamana Dev 是一个婆罗门。
But Shukracharya, the guru of Bali Maharaj, he was very suspicious.
但是呢 Shukracharya 也就是 Bali Maharaj 的宁心导师这个时候非常的小心，他不是很满意。
He thought he could understand that this Vamana Dev must be Vishnu. He's a friend of the demigods.
他这个舒卡查亚知道这个瓦玛拉德姆他其实是半神人们的朋友，他是主归属本人。
And so he told Bali Maharaj, don't give him the land.
所以他就跟巴尼马哈拉什说不要承诺把这个土地布施给瓦玛拉德姆。
Yeah. But Bali Maharaj, so I already promised, I offered, I told him, I give him whatever he wants.
但是巴利马哈拉就说,我已经做出了承诺,我已经告诉他我会给他三部土地。
But Sukracharya tells Bali Maharaj, take back your promise. Don't give him, he's going to cheat you.
但是舒卡尔查尔说,不要给他,他准,因为这个汪曼达对吧,准备欺骗你,拿回你的承诺。Yeah,
in this situation, there's no harm, there's no fault in your part if you don't keep your promise.
因为在这种情况下,对于你来说,并没有伤害,如果你拿回你的承诺的话。
Because there may be some danger for you if you keep your promise.
因为如果你这个时候保持你的承诺的话,你会遇上一些麻烦和危险。
So, in order to protect yourself, better you take back, don't keep your promise.
为了保护你自己,最好收回这个承诺。
So Sukracharya is telling Bali Maharaj, you know, better you don't give him. So Bali Maharaj was confused what to do.
Bali Maharaj 这个时候有一点迷惑，他不知道该做什么。
He began to think about it, and he thought, it's the duty of a householder to keep religious principles.
这个时候他就沉思,作为一个居士的职责,是应该维系宗教的原则。
And he thought, I've given my promise, I've given this promise to this brahmachari, it's not good if I take back my word.
他说,我这个时候如果收回我的承诺,对于一个婆罗门做出的这个承诺是不太适合的。
Yeah, I would be guilty of lying, I'd be guilty of telling a lie, that's very sinful.
我会对于这个说谎感觉到非常的罪恶,因为说谎是罪恶的这种活动。
And I've given my word to a brahmachari. Brahmachari is considered a very saintly person.
我是给一个真守身做出了承诺，而这个brahmachari真守身呢，他是一个被认，他应该被认为是非常圣洁的人。
And Bali Maharaj thought carefully. He thought it'd be very serious for me to tell a lie. I'll get sinful reactions for that.
巴尼马哈拉吉呢非常不想说谎，他认为说谎是罪恶的活动。Yeah,
it is said, Mother Earth can tolerate any weight on her planet. She can take any great weight. We see there are many mountains on the planet Earth, and Mother Earth can tolerate it.
因为地球母亲虽然可以承载很多的山峰的重量。 但是地球母亲却承载不了一位罪孽深重的这个说谎者的重负。Yeah.
So, it's important for me to show the right example for everyone.
对于我来说呢，我应该做出一个很好的榜样，对于普通大众。He
thought, what is the good of me ruling the heavenly planets if I cannot keep my promise?
如果我在这个天堂星球统治天堂星球的话，我不能做出一个很好的表率的话，那是不太好的。In
the past, there were many great men, they would sacrifice their life for others.
在过去，有很多人甚至牺牲自己来为了他人的这种利益。 为了普通大众的利益，甚至牺牲自己的利益，牺牲自己的生命。
We know after Bali Maharaj, there came a great king called Maharaj Dasarath, who was the father of Lord Ramachandra.
在巴利马哈拉什之后呢，还有一位伟大的国王叫Maharaj Dasarath, 他是主 Ramachandra 的父亲。
And he was also known for his truthfulness. He would rather die than tell a lie.
他也是由于他也是因为不说谎而非常闻名于天下，对于他来说宁愿死都不说谎。
And then also Maharaj Yudhisthira, he also had never told a lie.
Yudhisthira 也是不说谎而闻名于世，他从来不说谎。
And at one point Krishna wanted Maharaj Yudhisthira to tell a lie so they could trick Drona.But Maharaj Yudhisthira could not do it.
Krishna 想让 Yudhisthira 在这个战场上说 Drona 的这个事情的时候， Yudhisthira 说不出来，因为他不想撒谎。
So we see how these great men, they give so much importance to truthfulness.
所以我们看到了很多这些伟大的人物，他们是如何说真话。
So when people are very religious and pious in that way, then they are very glorious.
当人们非常虔诚，非常对于这个事情很严肃认真的时候，他们会非常荣耀，受到荣耀。
They have a very great reputation.
他们会因此而获得很好的名誉。
And that reputation is there for many, many years, for many generations.
这种名誉会带来很多年，甚至很多世代。
We see, like here, this Bali Maharaj, this pastime took place very long time ago, millions of years ago, on the higher planet.
我们看到巴利马哈拉吉的这个逍遥时光呢，发生在百万年之前。
But we are still observing that we still remember his glories. We speak about his activities on this particular day every year.
但是我们仍然在现在都在荣耀以及冥想他的这些逍遥时光，每一年的这个时候都在荣耀和冥想他的逍遥时光。
So Shukracharya is telling Bali Maharaj, if you give him charity, he'll take everything from you.
Shukracharya 就跟 Bali Maharaj 说，如果你答应这个承诺的话，这个 Vamanadeva 会把你的所有的一切都拿走。
But Bali Maharaj considered, well, if he's Vishnu, he could take everything anyway. I can't stop him.
这个巴利马哈拉吉就说，如果他真的是威士诺的话，他可以从任何方面任何角度都把你的东西拿走，你是无法阻止这个事情的。
Better I give him in charity than have him take it.
最好的方式呢，是我直接给予他，然后主威士诺接受。
Because if I give in charity, then I am get a good reputation.
如果我给予这个布施的话，我能够得到好的名誉。
And even I'll be very poor, I'll lose all my wealth, but I'll have a good reputation. So that's good.
即便我失去了一切，变得贫穷，非常的不好，但是呢，我得到了这个名誉，这仍将是非常好的一件事情。
So Bali Maharaj was considering that.His aim in life, he said, better to be famous. Better to be famous for giving charity than.
Bali Maharaj 就想着我这一生应最好是做一个名誉，就是给予这个布施获得名誉的这个一生是非常好的一件事情。
I said, even though if I give him charity, and even if he's Vishnu and he arrests me, I don't care.
即便他是Vishnu,他把我抓了起来, 我并不在乎。
I'm not envious of him.
我一点都不嫉妒他。
So in this way, Bali Maharaj decided to give everything to Lord Vishnu, to Vamanadeva.
这种方式之下呢，思考之后呢，巴尼马哈拉就准备把一切都给予这个妈妈的爹。
So when Sukracharya heard that Bali Maharaj was going to disobey his order, he was very angry.
当Sukracharya听到巴尼马哈拉准备把一切给予这个妈妈的爹的时候，他非常的生气。
And he cursed Bali Maharaj. He said that, for disobeying my order, you will lose all your wealth and you will go down to hell.
因为你违背了我的这个训示，所以呢，你将会失去一切，并下地狱。
So it's very interesting to see how Bali Maharaj could disobey the orders of his spiritual master.
这里呢，也是一个非常有趣的点，他是如何的
Now, we know the order of the spiritual master is very important. It's the life and soul of a devotee.
我们知道，灵性导师的训谕对于一个奉献者来说，是这个奉献者的生命和灵魂。
But we have to consider that the order which Sukracharya was giving to Bali Maharaj was wrong.
但是这个时候我们也得考虑，这个Sukracharya给予Bali Maharaj的训示是不对的。
So Bali Maharaj was justified in giving up the order of Sukracharya.
Bali Maharaj呢是做出了衡量，然后放弃了Sukracharya他的训示的。
Because Sukracharya, in the beginning, he was telling Bali to worship Vishnu.
因为Sukracharya在开始的时候，他告诉Bali Maharaj，应该崇拜主Vishnu。
And Bali Maharaj had become very powerful by doing this.
而Bali Maharaj也正是因为崇拜了Vishnu而变得有力量的。
But now, he was telling him to do something different.
但是现在，他却让巴利马哈拉吉做了完全不一样的事情。So
it was not an easy decision for Bali Maharaj to make.
这对于巴利马哈拉吉来说，并不是一个很容易的决定。Because
previously, when the demigods and the demons were fighting, during one battle, Bali Maharaj had been killed by the demigods.
因为在之前的这个战斗之中，巴利马哈拉吉和带着恶魔们和这个半神人之间打斗的时候，巴利马哈拉吉甚至被半神人给杀死了。
But Sukracharya, by his mystic powers, his yoga power, he could bring him back to life.
但是Sukracharya通过他的瑜伽玄秘力量，把巴利马哈拉吉
So we could understand Bali Maharaj had very great faith in Sukracharya. He owed his life to Sukracharya.
他因为他的生命是Sukracharya救回来。
But at the same time, Bali Maharaj is born in the family of a great devotee, Prahlad Maharaj.
Bali Maharaj呢，同时他也是非常伟大的奉献者，Prahlad Maharaj这个家庭中的人。
So Bali Maharaj has great respect for Lord Vishnu.
Bali Maharaj也对主 Vishnu 有非常大的尊敬之情。
And he thought, if Lord Vishnu is coming and he wants to take all the kingdom away from me, to take all the heavenly planets, then I should give it. I should give it in charity.
因此, 拿走一切的话,
so then, Bali Maharaj, rather Lord Vamanadev, took one step, he covered half the universe.
这个时候, Vamanadev, 他跨出了第一步,
and then the second step, he covered the other half of the universe.
他的第二步就把另外一半的整个宇宙给包囊括进去了。
So then, Bali Maharaj had lost all of his kingdom. So all the demons were very upset.
Bali Maharaj 呢就失去了他的国王的一切，恶魔们这个时候也非常的沮丧。
And the demons, they tried to fight Lord Vishnu.
这些恶魔们准备想跟主威士鲁。
But Bali Maharaj told them, no, don't fight.
Bali Maharaj 告诉恶魔们, 不要动手。
So they were all, anyway, the demons were all defeated by Lord Vishnu's associates.
无论如何, Bali Maharaj 的这些恶魔们全部被主威士鲁的, 同游们, 手下们, 全部给杀死了。
So they were defeated, not 没有杀死,
right?
Yeah, they were put into the lower planets of the universe.
他们被抓到一个非常放在一个很低的星球里面。
Yeah, the demons have their planet in the lower regions of the universe.
在这个整个宇宙之中呢，恶魔们也有他们非常他们的星球，他们是处在较低的星球里面。
So Lord Vamanadeva had only taken two steps. He was supposed to take three steps. So Garuda came and with the ropes of Vamanadeva, he arrested Bali Maharaj.
他就把巴利
Maharaj
给逮捕了起来。So
then Lord Vishnu said to him, "You told me I could get three steps of land. Where am I supposed to take the third step?"
这个时候主威士鲁就跟巴利马哈尔说，你答应了我要给我三部土地，那我的第三部土地这个时候在什么地方呢？
So Lord Bali Maharaj said, you can take that on my head.
这个时候巴利马哈尔就说，你可以把你的第三，你可以放在我的头上。
So Bali Maharaj impressed Lord Vishnu, he showed his great determination and his strong character and his determination to keep his promise.
这个时候呢，主威士鲁非常欣赏巴利马哈拉所献出的这种决心，以及对维持他的这个承诺的这种决心，主感觉到非常的印象深刻，非常的受感动。
Bali Maharaj was very eager that he should not give up his truthfulness. He wanted to keep that truthfulness.
Bali Maharaj 非常的渴望不放弃他的真诚、真实，就是不说谎的这个原则。
If somebody is known to be untruthful, it's a very big stain on their character.
Big stain.
Yeah, it's a dirty mark. considered that what he had done was a great success for him.
Bani Maharaj 认为自己做的这一切是非常成功的。
So Bali Maharaj is our acharya for one who surrenders everything.
Bali Maharaj 也是我们这个传习中的先辈明星导师 acharya 之一，他是把一切献出给了主。
There are 9 different ways in which we can perform bhakti yoga.
有九种方式我们可以做奉献服务的九种方式。
And one of them.Or the final one is Atmanivedanam, where you surrender everything.
最后一项叫 Atmanivedanam, 就是臣服，一切臣服于主，献给主。
So this process of devotional service is the most difficult to perform.
而这个最后一项呢，是最难从事的这个奉献服务。
Without being very, very advanced in Krishna consciousness, one cannot practice this process.
除非一个人在 Krishna 知觉之中非常非常的精进，否则他不可能达到这一步。
But Bali Maharaj, although he was from a demon family, and although he was fighting the demigods,So he was able to give up everything for Krishna.
但是巴利马哈拉吉，他即便出生在一个恶魔的家庭，即便和半神人作战，他仍然可以献出一切给至尊主。
And when Lord Vamanadeva put Bali Maharaj down to the heaven, he put him into the lower planet. He put him into the lower planet called.Sutala Loka.
主Vamanadev 把巴尼马哈拉吉带到了这个 Sutala 星球。当主把他放在那个星球的时候
，Yeah, and he put them there. Prahlad Maharaj also went there.
Prahlad Maharaj 当时也在这个星球，也去了那个星球。
And Lord Vamanadeva also went with him, he said, and I will be there, make sure nobody disturbs you.
当时 Vamanadeva 也去了这个星球，他当时想不让任何人来打扰巴尼马哈拉吉和他们。
So in this way, the demigods got back the heavenly planets.
这样的话，半神人们就得到了他们之前的这个天堂星球。
And Mother Aditi
返回了天堂星球。
Mother Aditi was happy. All her sons came back.
这个 Aditi 母亲呢，这个时候也开心了，因为她的孩子们都回来了。
And Bali Maharaj got released from being tied up by the ropes of Garuda.
巴利马哈拉吉被嘎鲁达给绑了起来。
And Prahlad Maharaj glorifies the Supreme Lord for creating the material world.
Prahlad Maharaj 就这个时候荣耀了至尊主，他荣耀至尊主创造了这个物质世界。
And for being equal to everyone.
以此对于每一个人都感到都平等的对待每一个人。
And he has, Prahlad Maharaj especially appreciates how kind the Lord is to his devotees.
Prahlad Maharaj 对至尊人格守神非常的感激，他是如何的仁慈的对待这个奉献者。
And the Lord is also very kind to the demons, not only to the devotees, he's also kind to the demons.
Prahlad Maharaj 非常感激至尊人格守神，他甚至对恶魔非奉献者都是非常仁慈的。
So in this way, the pastime of the appearance of Lord Vamanadeva is described.
这就是Vamanadeva 的这个逍遥时光。
Lord Vamanadeva resides in the heavenly planets as the son, one of the sons of Aditi and Kashyapa.
Vamanadeva,
Vamanadeva resides in the heavenly planets as the son of Kashyapa and Aditi.
Vamanadeva 停留在这个天堂星球的这个地方，他的这个 Kashyapa 和 Aditi 的儿子的旁边。
And this section of the Bhagavatam finishes by saying that the most auspicious thing for the conditioned soul to do is to chant and to hear about the activities of Lord Vishnu.
在国家梵歌之中，讲述了最吉祥的事情就是聆听和唱诵主威属的荣耀。
Okay, so we will stop and ask for some questions.
好，我们就讲到这儿。现在看一下大家的这个问题。
So have you got the questions?
Yes. 我看到的第一个问题是来自于 Rajendra Prabhu 的，感谢 Maharaj， 感谢翻译。有关于说谎，奉献者在任何情况下都禁止说谎吗？请问 Guru Maharaj， 奉献者是不是在任何情况下都禁止说谎
？Oh, should devotees should not tell lies in any situation?
奉献者在任何情况下都不应该说谎。
Yeah, truthfulness is an important quality of a brahmana.
一个说真话的人是一个婆罗门的品质。
The qualities of the brahmana are described in the 18th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita.
这个婆罗门的品质在第十八章《薄伽梵歌》第十八章讲述了。
Samodamas tapasocham shantir archavam evacha jnana vijnana mastikyam brahma karma svabhavajam. So truthfulness is one of the qualities of the brahmana.
说真话是婆罗门的其中一个品质。So Gurudev, he asked, Krishna 说过谎，帕布帕德的咕噜说过谎。当然，我们不能模仿伟人的行为，在危险的情况下，也不应该说谎吗 ？Gurudev， 在传播圣名的时候，一次谎都不应该有吗？
So, can you translate that from the beginning？
感谢 Maharaj， 感谢 Prabhu。有关于说谎，奉献者在任何情况下都禁止说谎，说谎吗？奉献者是不是在任何情况下都禁止说谎 ？Krishna， 因为 Krishna 也说过谎，帕帕德的咕噜说过的咕噜说过谎。当然，我们不能模仿人的行为，在危险的情况下也不应该说谎吗？在传播圣名的时候，一次谎都不应该有吗？He asked, devotee should, whether devotee should.Tell lies at any situation because Krishna tell lie, Prabhupada's guru tell lie. Of course, we should not imitate the great sages' activities. So, in dangerous situation, should we not tell lie? And when we preach the holy name, any lies we should not tell?
We should be very careful not to make a habit of telling lies.
我们应该非常小心，不要有说谎的这种习惯，非常非常小心。
Yeah, there may be some very special situation, where a life-threatening situation, where you have to tell a lie.
我们或许有一些这种有关于生命的这种状况的时候的时候。不得已要去说谎。
Just like there's a story, the one man was being chased by thieves. This one man was carrying a lot of money, and the thieves were chasing him.
就像我们之前讲过或听过一个故事，有一个人呢，他拿着很多的钱，后面有一个贼在追他。
So the man with the money went to run and hide in the forest.
这个人准备把钱藏在一个森林里面。
那、no, 他自己跑进去森林，想躲在森林，啊、huh? ？
就是这个人想带着钱躲进森林里面。
And so the thief came running, and he didn't know where the man had gone with the money.
这个贼就盯上了这个人，他不知道前面这个人往哪个方向走了。
Then he saw the Brahmana who was sitting there, and he asked the Brahmana, "Did you see that man? Where did he go?"
于是他这个时候看到了一个婆罗门，他就问这个婆罗门，坐在这个路上的这个婆罗门，你知道前面那个人去了哪个地方吗？
So the Brahmana thought, "I've made a vow to be truthful." So he told the thief where the man had gone.
这个婆罗门呢，就想我应该变得真诚，说谎不说谎，所以呢，他如实的告诉了这个贼，这个前面这个男人去向了什么地方。
So the thief went into the forest and he found the man and he killed him and took all of his money.
所以这个贼就跟着这个婆罗门所说的这个话，去到了这个森林里面，找到了这个男人，杀了他，然后夺走了他的钱。
So the Brahmana was guilty for causing the death of that man.
这个婆罗门就感觉到非常的罪恶，因为是他的原因造成了这个人的死亡。
So we have to know there are special situations where sometimes we may have to lie.
我们知道有一些，我们也得知道有一些情况下，我们不得已会去说一些谎。
Just like sometimes we go for sankirtan, we go to chant, and we were sometimes in the street chanting and dancing and doing book distribution.
就像我们有的时候在大街上做这个派书、做 sankirtan 运动的时候。
So people, somebody may come and they say, "Have you got permission to be here?"
有些人就会质疑我们，你得到了这个许可在这里派书和做活动吗？
So we will just say yes, we have permission.
我们就会很自信地说，是的，我们得到了许可。
We may not have permission, but we may just simply say, yeah, we have permission.
我们可能没有得到允许，但是我们也会说我们得到了允许。是的，我们得到了允许。
Because on the absolute sense, on the higher sense, on the spiritual platform, we are authorized, we have permission.
嗯，因为在更高的这种原则和权威的这种理解情况下之呢，我们确实是得到了允许的。
But we don't want to make a habit that every day we tell lies and cheat people.
但是我们不应该养成一个欺骗、说谎的习惯。
Just like Prabhupada told devotees that if they sell books and collect money, telling people that we're feeding people, we're using the money to feed people, then we should do that. We have to use the money to feed people.
嗯，就像帕布帕德也告诉奉献者，如果你去派书的时候告诉别人。你拿到的这个书的布施的这个钱是用来，给穷人喂这个大餐的话，你应该如实的拿着这个钱去做你说的这个行为，去派发食物给穷人。
He said it will be very bad for our movement if we're always lying to people.
如果我们这个运动中总是欺骗的话，是非常不好的。对于我们的运动是非常不好的。
So we collect money for food distribution. It must be used for food distribution.
如果我们拿到了这个钱，跟别人解释说我们是用来派发食物的，那我们就真的应该去派发食物，用这个钱。
If we collect money for feeding people in India, the money should go to India.
如果这个钱是从印度来了。
No.
那么这个钱，
If we collect money, saying that we are feeding people in India, then the money should go to India.
哦，就是说，如果我们跟别人说我们这个钱是要为在印度派发这个食物的话，我们这个钱也确实应该到达印度去派发食物。
We should not lie.
我们不应该说谎。
Okay.
Rajendra Prabhu 又说 Bani Maharaj 是献出一切给主的典范，这个最难做到，做不到怎么办？可以做不到吗？So Bani Maharaj is an example of the surrender all everything to the Lord. This is the most difficult things we can do, most difficult thing to do. So if we can't do, cannot do, is okay?
What we should do is hear and chant.
我们应该做的是聆听和唱诵。
Just like at the end of the chapter, that's the message which is given in the Bhagavatam, that we should hear and chant about the activities of the Lord.
就像在这个《博伽瓦坛》刚刚我们讲的这个逍遥时光的最后的这个里面的结论一样，我们应该聆听和唱诵这个主的荣耀。
To try to become Krishna's friend.Or to surrender everything, one has to be very advanced devotee.
想成为主的朋友，想把一切都献给主，这个必须是非常精进的奉献者。
But everybody can do things like hearing and chanting.
但是每一个人都可以做聆听和唱诵。
And by hearing and chanting,We will become purified. One day we will be able to surrender everything.
当一个人聆听和唱诵的时候，有一天他进化到一定的程度的时候，他就可以做到这一切。
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. And Rajendra Prabhu, 痛苦是因为做了表面上的服务，但是动机是为了取悦自己的感官。如果是为了取悦 Krishna 才会有快乐，主人快乐，仆人也自动会获得快乐。问题是，不痛苦也不快乐怎么办 ？So, the suffering because we do the activities surface superficial, but the active the motivation is to enjoy the sense, enjoying the sense. If we want to please Krishna, if we please Krishna, then we can can be happy. The Lord be happy, and the servant will be happy. So the question is, if not painful and not happy,
what to do? If we're not
yeah.
If we're not happy and we're not what?
Not suffering.
Well, you don't have to worry. These things come very quickly, all the time, happiness and suffering. They're coming and going all the while. You don't have to wait long.
这个痛苦和快乐，你不用担心，痛苦和快乐总是会来来去去。它不会停留很长的时间。
Still, our duty is to give pleasure to Krishna.
我们的这个，一直不断的这个职责是把快乐给予 Krishna， 为了 Krishna 的快乐。
Suffering and happiness are all in the mind.
痛苦和快乐其实是内心的这个心意的感受。
One day we think I'm suffering, another day we think I'm happy.
有一天我们认为自己，快乐；有一天我们会认为自己痛苦。
Nothing changed, but just the mind changed.
其实并没有什么的变化，只是心意的变化而已。
But our business is to remember Krishna and to serve Him.
我们的这个工作就是取悦 Krishna， 服务 Krishna。
We see Bali Maharaj, he was tied up like a prisoner, but he didn't think I'm suffering. He remembered to serve Krishna, surrender to Krishna.
我们看到这个巴尼马哈拉吉，他也不害怕这个痛苦，他就是准备去服务 Krishna。
Everything was taken from him.
一切都来自于 Krishna.
He had so much. He conquered the heavenly planets.
这个巴尼马哈拉吉他征服了天堂星球都。
But he didn't lament when everything was taken from him.
但是呢，当一切被拿走的时候，他并不感到悲伤。
He thought he's very lucky he could give everything.
他感觉到非常的幸运，如果能够把一切都给予至尊主的话。
So devotees should be happy in every situation. We should be equipoised. We should control the mind. Be steady.
所以奉献者应该在任何情况下都感觉到快乐的，在任何情况下都很稳定的控制自己的心意。
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. The next question from Maturnila. 顶拜孤儿的莲花族，巴利马哈拉吉是伟大的灵魂，我们是不是在任何情况下也不能模仿巴尼马哈拉吉不听孤儿的训示？ So Bani Maharaj is a great soul. So whether should we to imitate Bani Maharaj, not listen his guru's instructions?
Well, you have
in any situation.
You have to be intelligent to understand.What kind of instructions your guru is giving? Is he giving the proper instruction or not?
所以你应该非常具有智慧的去理解你的灵性导师是不是给予的恰当的训示。
If he's not giving a proper instruction, then you can disobey.
一夫
If he does not give you the proper instruction,Then you don't have to follow.
如果不是给予了你恰当的训示话，你可以违背。
If the guru tells you to do something sinful, you don't do it.
如果灵性导师告诉你去做一些罪恶的活动，你不应该做。
You have to be intelligent.
你应该有智慧。
Don't just be a blind follower.
不要仅仅成为一个盲目的追随者。
Oh, my guru told me I should do this, so I did it.
Oh, 我的灵性导师告诉我应该做这个，所以我应该做这个。
My guru told me go and rob the bank.
我的灵性导师告诉我去抢银行。
And then when you get arrested and put in the jail, you say, my guru told me.
然后你被这个逮起来进了监狱，你就想，哦，这是我的guru告诉我的。
No, we have to be intelligent. Know what to do, what we should do and what we shouldn't.
因此我们应该有智慧，知道什么是该做的，什么是不该做的。
还有问题
？OK， 还有一个问题，下一个问题是来自于 Radha Priya Mataji， 顶拜孤儿的莲花族，感恩翻译和主持的服务。您刚才讲到巴利马哈拉吉完全臣服皈依至尊主，我们如何追随他完全臣服的心态呢 ？So how we should follow the Bani Maharaj? All surrenders. This.Motivation. How do we follow Bani Maharaj?
Well, we can keep our vow of truthfulness.
So, 我们应该保持一个誓言，就是真诚的说真话的誓言。
Just like Bali Maharaj was so attached to being truthful.He sacrificed everything to be truthful.
就像巴尼马哈拉吉，他献出了一切，就只是为了说真话，
So we should try to be truthful. We made vow to chant 16 rounds and to follow four principles. We should try to follow that strictly.
So we actually also made a promise, for example, this 四项基本原则, we should be very strict to follow this 四项基本原则.
That's following Bali Maharaj.
Mahgurudev, she asked how should we follow Bali Maharaj like him, full surrender to the Lord.
Yes, well, this is full surrender.
这就是全然的臣服。
We're not ready to surrender everything. I explained that. I said that we can't do that.
我已经讲过了，我们做不到这个。我们现在还做不到全然的臣服。
You have to hear and chant properly.
我们这个时候应该做的是聆听和唱诵，恰当的聆听和唱诵。
And keep the regulative principles and maintain the chanting.
保持我们的规范原则，好的唱诵。
We're not ready to surrender everything.
我们现在还没有达到献出一切的完全臣服的状态。
It's a very high level of devotional service to surrender everything.
这是一个非常高的这个层面，对于奉献服务来说。
How can you even think of doing it?
你怎么能做到这个呢？
First of all,do the basics first. Get the basics right first.
第一步呢，先做好基础的事情，把基础的事情做好。
Hear and chant properly.
很恰当的聆听和唱诵。
下一个问题。
下一个问题 from Hanivamsa Prabhu.顶拜孤乳，我们都很为圣地的奉献者担心，不知道现在玛雅普的疫情是具体什么样的真实情况，有些媒体描述得很严重，不知道他们有没有说谎，说假话有什么坏处。 So obeisance to Guru Gurudev, we are all very worried about the devotees from the Holy Dhamma. We don't know the real situation of the Maya devotees. What's the real of the situation of them? On the social media, described is very dangerous here, dangerous in the Holy Land. Whether, I don't know whether they are telling the lie. And if tell the lie, what's the bad things for tell lie?
Well, there's danger everywhere.
在每一个地方都很危险。
We have to always remember Krishna.
我们应该在每一个，我们应该总是想着 Krishna.
Yeah, there are a number of devotees who were affected with the COVID virus.
确实有一些奉献者被这个新冠病毒给感染了。
So the temple was closed, but the deity worship is maintained.
虽然庙宇关闭了，但是呢，庙里面的这个神像崇拜的服务还一直在维系着。
And the sick devotees, they're isolated.
这个生病的奉献者 isolate,
put in quarantine, what do we say, quarantine? Gobiya. Gradually they're getting better. Most of the devotees who were sick, they're young people, so they can get over it quite easily.
因为他们都是一些很年轻的人，所以他们很容易就会恢复。
But there is a lot of people affected in India, not just in Mayapur, but all over India. Many people affected.
整个印度都有很多的人被感染。
So we have to be careful.
所以我们应该小心。 And finally he asked, what's the harm in telling the lies?
But what's the benefit in telling the lie? There's no benefit. The harm
没有,
is sinful.
说话是罪恶的。
We should speak the truth.
我们应该说真话。
But we should try to speak the truth in a way in which is palatable, which should be pleasing to others.
我们说真话有两个方面，第一要愉悦他人，既是说真话又愉悦他人。
But if we tell lies, it doesn't do any good for anybody.
但是如果我们说假话的话，说谎话，不会对任何人有任何的帮助。
Okay, 还有问题吗？
还有， Brother Priya 继续说，请问Guru，我的理解，我们今生能够完全遵循Guru的训示。 我们今生如果能够完全遵循Guru的训示，足够成功了，对吗？ If we follow the Guru's instruction in this life, is enough for us? Is enough successful?
Yes, we hope so.
我们希望如此。
Prabhupada said, you follow the four principles, you chant every day 16 rounds. At the end of the life, at the end of the life, Krishna will come take you back to God.
圣帕帕德说，你遵循四项基本原则，念诵好16圈，在生命的末尾的时候， Krishna 会把你带回首身，回到首身。
还有问题吗？
还有，Govindanandini Mataji， 顶拜Guru，感谢翻译，做服务不稳定怎么办？ 有时候念诵的很多，有时候念诵的很少，而且没有品味。有时候早上起来的很早，有时候又没办法早起。有时候白天需要做很多的服务，怎样才能让自己变得非常的规律和稳定？
Well, you have to control your mind.
你应该控制你的心意。
You have to be more regulated. This is very bad to be so irregular.
你应该非常的有规律，没有规律的生活是非常的糟糕的。
I know having a child makes some difficulties for you.
我知道有一个小孩对于你们来说是很困难。
But the child is going to grow up very quickly. And the child has to be regulated. If you're not regulated, how will you ever regulate the child? So very important, you get yourself, get a schedule, make your schedule, and you try to keep that schedule.
你安排你好你的时间表，然后呢，尽量保持好这个时间表，去按照这个时间表上去做。
I know family life can be very unstable, difficult to keep schedule.
我知道这个家庭生活是非常难的去维系一个稳定的状态。
But you have to try to be steady, at least with your chanting.
但是呢，你至少应该让你的念诵变得很稳定。You have to have
some regulation, as much as you can. You have to really try to be regulated.
你不能每一个方面做得 很规律吧，至少有一些地方你得做得很规律。
At the same time, you can't be too much attached to this.
同时呢，你不应该太依附于这种情况。
But do your best and try to be steady.
但是呢，要尽可能做得好，尽可能变得稳定。
还有问题。
还有一个问题来自于 Brajarani Mataji Dimbai Gurudev 有个奉献者为了念诵质量专注在音阵上有时候完成不了十六圈这样可以吗他说专注比十六圈更重要可以这样念诵吗 Obeisance to Gurudev one devotee saidTo the quality of the chanting should be very attention to the sound vibration. But she can't chant 16 rounds. Is that okay? The quality and the 16 rounds, which is important, whether we should attentive chanting and not 60 rounds, is that okay to chant like this?
No, it's not okay. You must do 16 rounds.
不可以，应该是念诵十六圈，必须十六圈。
If you're initiated, at the time of initiation, you promise 16 rounds.
尤其是对于这个起义的奉献者起义的时候你发下的誓言是要念诵十六圈
So quantity minimum quantity 16 rounds
最少的圈数是十六圈
You can't we cannot accept less
你不应该让这个十六圈，你不应该少于十六圈。
还有问题吗？
这个是来自于叫静华的妈的姐，顶拜孤队，怎样区分奉献者之间的物质的友情与灵性的友爱呢 ？How to distinguish the devotee's relationship, which is the material friendship?Which is the spiritual friendship in the devotees around between the devotees? Which is the material friendship? Which is the spiritual friendship?
Spiritual friendship is based on Krishna conscious activities.
灵性的友爱基础于 Krishna 知觉
Material friendship is just based on the bodily conception.
而物质的友情仅基是来自于躯体化的概念。
Spiritual friendship is very important for us.
灵性的友谊对于我们来说非常的重要。
Will help us to advance in Krishna consciousness.
这个灵性的友谊会帮助我们在 Krishna 知觉之中取得进步。
还有问题吗？
加格泰什瓦瑞德维达西，顶拜古尔德，感谢翻译，顶拜所有的奉献者。如果都说真话，有的人要是接受不了怎么办 ？If everyone tells the truth, how about they? If somebody can't accept this truth, how to do?
Well.Everyone has their own free will. It's up to them. If they don't want to accept the truth, what can we do about it? We can't change the truth just for them.
Because every person has their own free will, we can't change the truth just for them. Because every person has their own free will, we can't change the truth just for them. 我们改变不了那些人。
还有问题？
还有问题吗？没了。
哦、OK。好，我们 ，so tomorrow is the day of appearance day of Lord Brahmanadev. This morning we're supposed to fast eat half day.
明天是这个主巴曼的 Dev 的这个显现日，本来是要戒食半天的。
We fast eat today for tomorrow because tomorrow is Dwadasi. We break the fast tomorrow.
因为明天是 Dwadasi， 我们明天是打破戒食。今天是阿格达西，我们今天已经为明天戒食了半天。
Okay, so thank you very much.
感谢 Gurudev， 顶拜 Gurudev， Hare Krishna。
谢谢。
谢谢
Subhuti Rai Prabhu, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki jai,
jai,
Sati Mataji ki jai, Sati Mataji, ni zai ma?
是的 ，Gurudev 我在。
Okay， 我们结束了。
Gurudev，
可以啊。
好的，顶拜您。
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna， 谢谢 Gurudev。